the Wood family, and oh God, all of those that have suffered losses this week, stretch out your hand, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we're going to praise you today. We're going to magnify you. Ah, we're going to glorify you. The devil don't want us to praise you. The devil don't want us to have church here. But Lord, I know you're able. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Pray in the name of Jesus. Thank God. And amen. And amen. Joy bells keep ringing in my soul. I hear those joy bells keep ringing. I hear those joy bells. I hear those joy bells keep ringing in my soul. I hear those joy bells keep ringing. I hear the joy bell. make a way somehow. But somebody tell him, somehow. West side of Detroit on Schaefer at West 7 Mile Road. God bless you. You tune in weekly. Certainly to our good friends, the Shire family. We're still praying for you, Lyndon, the sons and daughter. We know what you're going through. We're with you in your grief. But God is still making a way. I say God is still making a way. He just keeps on doing great things for me. God keeps on doing great things for me. If I had 10 pounds name with everyone. You know what? If I had 10 pounds of hands, I would use them all to bless this man. You know why? 'Cause he knows me better, so much better than anyone else. And I love this today, and he takes better care of me that I do for myself. Oh, he keeps doing for me. Oh, right on. Outside of Chicago, but down through the years, God's been mighty, 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 mighty good to me. Woo. My, 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 my. ought to get somebody upset, just lean on him a little bit and say, I know he's been cooked. And I'm gonna move on. If you don't want to praise him, don't you hinder me. In the book of James again, one more time. My God, I just feel like praying. Hit somebody and tell them, I just feel like praying. Just tell them, if you don't want to praise him, don't hinder me. Thank you. In the book of James, I'm going to soon be done here. Yes, again, we read here in the book of James. Blessed is the man that endured temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Let's feel like praising him, that's all. Mighty good, mighty good, mighty good. Just touch somebody and say, he's been mighty good. Touch somebody else and say, he's good right now. Help yourself, child. Help yourself. Mighty good. say they call the devil. Oh, the devil is a liar and a deceiver too. Because God is not through. In God. Again today, faith in God. Without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he that cometh to God, I quote from Hebrews 11 and 6, must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. Faith in God will bring you out of anything. And I might close this today. I might get through. I don't know. But faith in God can do it. The miraculous, the supernatural, whatever. Faith in God can do it. Some persons that were blessed by Jesus, as they went, they were healed. And some, right now, when He said, go to the pool of Siloam and wash, immediately He came back seeing. Some had to dip in Jordan 7 times. And they came back whole at the 7th time. Some were healed and went on about their business. But I remember 1 out of 10. Lord, I miss it. We ain't gonna run here today now, y'all. But I feel like it. I feel like another run. I feel like a balcony run. I feel like I run up there today, y'all. I go. One of them discovered, look, the leprosy gone. And I don't know what your 9 gonna do. But I got to go back and tell Jesus, thank you. Thank you. Somebody today, because of your faith in God, you've got to come on back and tell Him, thank you. Put that up there today. Just tell Him, thank you. My. See, when you just tell Him thank you, you've got so much to thank Him for. The good times and the bad. The heat and the cold. The winnings and the lose, the losses. And I'm not talking about gambling. Hearing so much about it until y'all may think I'm talking about that. I ain't talking about that. You win some battles and you lose some. You lose them because you lose faith in God, who promised to bring you out. You win them because you keep up with the winner. And I definitely want to keep up with the winner. Lord, deliver me from losers. I'm tired of being around losers. Folks that don't have no faith. Just every time I look around, they have a sad story to sing. Head in the lap almost. Praise the Lord. Hardly any tears of joy. Always sad tears. Sad song to sing. How you feel today, baby? Well, I'm just middling. What y'all call it? Fat and middling. That is. I'm just fat and middling, you know. How you, honey? Well, I'm just blessed anyhow. Come on up out of them dumps. My God, I don't care what you're going through. Blessed is the man that endured temptation. Sometimes up, sometimes down, sometimes you don't know what to do. But by the help of God, I'm on my way. I'm moving forward. Because I know that if he doesn't do it today, he's still able. That's where your victory is. He's able. Yes. Somebody say able.
Able.
Hallelujah. I got to take a plane here in a few minutes. I got to get through here some kind of way. But I don't know. This faith has been on me.
Come on, God.
And you know, faith for everything, not just some things. Just faith to believe you that you can make it.
Yes.
Amen. Faith to believe that everything's gonna be all right.
Yes.
I don't care how hard it is around you, just it's gonna be all right. Tap somebody lightly and tell them it's going to be all right. Look at somebody and say, what you worrying about? Thank God you worrying about something you can't do nothing about anyhow. What you worrying about? God's going to bring it out all right. God's going to fix it. God's going to make a way. And I come to tell you, wherever he is, the way is already made. He ain't got to do nothing. He's already fixed it. When he put you in it, he knew how he was going to bring you out. Faith will help you. Faith can move mountains. Faith can open up fountains. Faith can shut the devil up. Hallelujah. I don't want you to make anybody angry by you, but just tell him, shut that demon up in you. The very one didn't touch nobody. He's got more demons than everybody else. That's the reason he didn't touch nobody. See, I don't care who you are. There's a demon that comes to you every now and then. Every once in a while, you wake up with him, and you call it getting up on the wrong side of the bed. You call it your pedigree. You know, it got engine in your blood and all that. But I ain't stunned about all that stuff. Hey, amen. You know, I'm pure Negro. I'm pure. I don't care what you are. You ought to be pure saint. And a saint can take anything. A saint can be lied on and keep on dancing. A saint can be talked about and keep on speaking in tongues. A saint can be pushed aside and still have his joy. Because there's something that God gives a saint. He don't give it to everybody else. And that's a joy and a peace that the world can't steal. Nobody can take the saint's joy. Nobody can take the saint's peace. Tell somebody, not even you. Am I in the right church here? This faith thing goes a long way. It's beyond just not taking medicine or going to the doctor. Hallelujah. I'm glad to have a medical doctor in the room to take care of that child that went out with that seizure a minute ago. I'm glad to have somebody to look after and trained and whatever and so forth. But let me tell you, it goes farther than that. The doctor can't stop the seizure. But the God I serve, see, he knows how to do it. Praise the Lord. Can I testify just a minute here? Some of you heard me say it before. My fourth child, praise the Lord, was born hemorrhaging February 15, 1961. And thank God how they didn't know what was the problem and whatever. And I wanted a boy so badly at that time, only had one son. And here comes another daughter, the third daughter in the midst of one son. I didn't want all them girls. No, it's too much problem with girls. You got to sit around with your shotgun loaded, watching the fellas, and you got to sit around with a baseball bat. Oh, where you come from, boy? I didn't want all that problem. I wanted a lot of boys. But however, that was something in me that didn't, you know, want to be too receptive. But the Lord let the child be born sick, and I had to. Well, I was running out of Detroit at that time, and I had to come in here, and I prayed, Lord, have mercy. Bless that child. They shaved all the little hair back, trying to find a vein to put a, give a blood transfusion and whatever. And you know, she had that and came out all right. And I called back home after praying. The Lord stopped the blood. My wife told me, said, the blood stopped. There is no more hemorrhaging. I said, thank God, thank God. Amen. Moved on here to Detroit in 62. And before she was 2 years old, or right after she was 2 years old, she started having seizures. We didn't know what it was all about. But our plan, come in and take a nap, and she'd have a seizure. And it was uncontrollable. And the first time she had it, we rushed her down to the children's hospital. Didn't even know where it was hardly at that time, being new in the city. Got down there, and they said, oh, the child suffered a stroke and whatever and whatever. Oh, Lord, a stroke, not a stroke. We don't need a stroke victim child, whatever. But we prayed and they kept overnight and looked at her, whatever, and that did not heal her. And after that, she made frequent trips to the hospital, children's hospital. She was known there, being there confined different periods of time for those seizures. And as she grew up, she had to take phenobarbital, one a day, one in the morning, one in the evening, or something like that. However, and as she began to grow and whatever, she got on up some size there as a youngster, and she told her mama and I one day, she said, you know, I don't want no more of that medicine. I don't want to take those pills anymore. I don't feel I need them. Praise the Lord. Now, we knew the doctor said she would take them all of her life. Praise the Lord. But we were praying that she wouldn't have to. And we reluctantly said, well, baby, if you feel that way. She knew how to go up in the cupboard and get them and take them herself and all that kind of stuff. But we said, well, if that's the way you feel about it, we will not force you to take them. But if you have a seizure, bless God, then you will have to go back and start taking them. But I'm here to tell you that child went, thank God, for months and months and months. And you know, sometimes your faith is not as strong as somebody else, even as a child. I'm looking for a seizure. I'm wondering, when is it going to happen? When is it going to take place? And God didn't let no seizure take place. And my God, now today, you know how old she is, about 31, 33 years old. And even up to today, she doesn't have to take not one pill for any seizure whatsoever. God came by and healed her body. She's grown. She has two children. She doesn't suffer any side or ill effects from those things. And then somebody want to tell me what God can do. You see, you got what God can't do. Let me tell you something. You got to put your trust in God. You got to believe there ain't nothing. My God, somebody help me say nothing. There ain't nothing too hard for God. I don't care what you're going through. He's able, and he will undertake for you. Praise the Lord. And some of you in this room, I just want to tell you, you are relying on some medicines and things that God don't want you to have no longer, because he's already healed your body. Can you hear me? Praise the Lord. Now, if you have the faith, so be it unto you. I'm not dictating, trying to get you to go against your doctor's recommendations and whatever, but if you have the faith, praise the Lord, because I'm not medically experienced enough to tell you don't do this and don't do that. But I'm here to tell you, God is able, and as your faith, so be it unto you. Hallelujah. If any of you ever had this experience, you thought you had to take something, you found out you didn't need it after all, because God had already healed your body. Hallelujah. I just want to tell you something here now today. There are many of you in here that are recovering from various things. Praise the Lord. Yes, there are recovering addictions here. People that were addicted to this and that and the other. But let me tell you something. I want to preach this right quickly here and tell you. I want to strengthen your faith in God now. Stop going around telling folks I am recovering. And I want you to come on and just claim the victory. Do you hear what I'm saying? Let's stop. Let's stop right now saying, well, I'm doing better than I used to do. No, 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 no. But every day that you open your eyes, I want you to thank God today because I am delivered. I am delivered right now. I want to thank him. I want to bless his name right now because I am free. Don't look at it and try to wean off. Don't let them give you some other drug to substitute another drug. But by faith, step out on God and speak of those things that are not as if they are right now. Amen. Claim it right now. Say, I am healed. You already got your tonight. Do you believe in God? Now? Touch somebody and say, now. Now. Well, you see, the Lord gonna deliver me after a while. Now. God didn't wait 2 days to forgive your sins. He did it now. He don't have to wait till next week to heal your body. He did it now. Hallelujah. Let me just say this. If you got an affliction, right now, just lift your hands to the Lord. Watch God. See, a lot of you think you got to get in the prayer line. A lot of you think you got to be greased with oil. I dare you just by faith. See, I'm preaching some faith here. Just by faith. Say, I'm healed. I'm not looking for the doctor any longer. I'm healed. I'm not going back in the hospital. I'm healed. Hallelujah. I just believe it and come on and praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I bless you today. And I challenge somebody to come and serve this great God, who is our healer, who is our deliverer, who will save you. Not join the church, but come on and get saved.